The fact of the matter remains with us is that we could have met actually 7 years back. I mean, she was in a college wherein I also got an admission. I did not go to that college. She was in IFT. I got an admission to IFT, but I did not go to IFT. I went to IIM Indore. And she had come to my house in Calcutta in 2017 also. I probably did not even look at her. I just said a hi, and she stayed in my house with a common friend. And I didn't even speak to her at that point of time. She had come to attend the wedding of those two very people who actually ended up making us meet. So yeah, it's a convoluted sort of a story, but yes. Just one word, happy. I mean, that is one thing that defines the companionship that we have, happiness. And when I'm with her, I'm happy.
Pavan, our son, has worked throughout his life and now deserves Prachi, who is also very intelligent, very beautiful, and also good at heart, basically. And heart is in the right place, and we love that. You know, that is the most important thing.
I think they're quite meant for each other. I mean, I suppose they feel that work-wise also they have identical work plans. They supposedly have like interests, and they have known each other for precisely about 8 to 9 months now, so they understand each other. And because they're in the same work process, supposedly that is going to be a lot of help for them. I think they'll have a wonderful journey together.
The first thing I'm looking forward to is being together, because we have been apart for a very long time. We have had a very long courtship period. which has not been, you know, the regular situation as it is for other people. So the main thing is that I get to spend more time with him, be with him. Yes, that is the thing that I look forward to in a very short frame of time if I speak about it. And in the longer run, I want us to make a lot of memories, to cherish each other, to respect each other, and you know, have a lot of fun along the way.
And supposedly they're going to be in Bombay, so supposedly we'll be very much in touch with them. So I think it's going to work out. The family also is supposedly very good. We have absolutely, we couldn't have got anything better. And because he's the only son and she's probably the only daughter left, I think it's going to work out very well. I think we are truly blessed.
I can't tell you that how amazing a friend that you've been to me. I mean, how lucky Pavan is to have you, because I remember in 7th standard we had a skit where we both were partners, and I forgot all my lines because I got stage fright. And in the stage you are literally like whispering each line to me, and I'm like repeating the same thing. We made such a big fool of ourselves. But you know, that's how the person that you are. You're so reliable, you're so loving, and you care about somebody beyond your own. He lost the skit, but I gained a friend for life. So can we put our hands together once again, please?
Kangana, Shangana, and along the dance.
very genuine human being. He opens up to very few people, but when he does, he goes all out. In whatever little span of time I've known him, he has been a thorough gentleman with me. Whether we get along or not, he's never let it affect his attitude, behavior and nature towards me, and I really respect him for that.
Say probably about 6 months on this entire period, which was supposedly dampened because of COVID. This entire year we have been with them, and supposedly Pavan has been a wonderful son-in-law. I mean, it is supposedly, we're lucky to have him as a son-in-law. I think we are truly blessed, both of us. Shuru hua hai, main tera musafir, tu mera rasta. Ye safar mera tere sang shuru hua hai, main tera musafir, tu mera rasta. Aadatein teri hone lagi.
When I met Pavan first, I was like, he is the guy for you, Prachi. He can understand you, I'm sure, and he's a good listener, because our Prachi is a big blabber box and she needs someone to sit and listen to her. So I think Pavan is the right choice that she's made for herself, and I wish them lots of love.
तेरे ख्यालों को ही दुनिया बना के अब मैं रहता हूँ सबसे बेखबर एक पल का फासला भी तुझसे गवारा ना हो ताउम्र का है ये सफर सौ मर्तबा तेरे लिए अपने खुदा से वादे मैंने किए इश्क मेरा तेरे काबिल हो गया देख ले मैं तेरा हो गया देख ले मैं तेरा हो गया तुझसे मिलके पूरा हो गया देख ले मैं तेरा
If I had to describe Prachi in a word, it is cheerful and happy. She's always happy no matter what the situation is, and that's, I think, the biggest quality and biggest asset that she brings into my life also. Because whatever be the situation, she brings a smile to her face, and I'm actually left with no choice but to smile back at her. So that's the best part of us, and that's the best part of her as a person.
जाने कैसी हलचल है
I always tell myself that I don't wear glasses because I have two daughters and supposedly they have been my eyes. So I have never had any problems with both of them. They've been really great, very disciplined, very, very endearing, supposedly very, very work focused. They've been wonderful as children.
Prachi, I find her a very friendly girl. Even when whosoever enters the house first, she always welcomes them. And that is the best part, whether it is a servant or a maid, anybody who comes. I love her. I like her approach to life and bless her for a very successful life.
But yes, it is finally happening. So we are sort of more relieved than happy, I feel. I mean, ke finally ho raha hai. And right now also it's happening in the middle of a lockdown. So yeah, relief is the right word to put across rather than anything else.
I can have no words to say what about Prachi, because they say we are siblings, but to me she's not a sibling. A difference of 6 years, but it's like a younger daughter getting married today for me. So I used to always tell anyone that if ever I have babies,
They're going to be my second one because my first baby is Prachi. And today's a wonderful day for me to see her become a bride. It's like a dream come true for me. And more so a dream that's so beautiful because it's with a wonderful person called Pavan.
I expected him to call me and speak, but in true Pavan style, he was shy, I guess, and he sent me a long WhatsApp message. And after that, we met for the first time, and since then, I guess we haven't stopped talking. We have had our ups and downs in terms of going through a long distance relationship, our wedding being postponed, COVID lockdown, but we've made it this far.
I hope to see you on the other side now and hope to be the same actually, no surprises in fact. I would want to continue the same with you after the ceremonies are done. Want to continue living the life that we have been living so far as well, but together now in totality.
Madhaniya, hai be mere daade ya rabba, kina jamiya kina ne le jaaniya, hai be mere daade ya rabba, kina jamiya kina ne le jaaniya.
We truly bless them, I mean both of us. I feel we are always there, and in case any problems, any emergency, any financial help, we'll always be there. And somehow, somewhere, I feel that in the profession that they are in, they both worship the profession. they won't be needing much of help of any sort, but still I feel that in case they ever need us, we'll always be there.
As long as he has me by his side, I think we can weather anything. We have already done a lot of it, so I guess we can fight any challenge that comes our way. So that's all I can say, that just buckle up and, you know, we are in it to win it.
Life is full of compromise and adjustments. We wish them all good luck and bless them that they make the most of their life and be successful in all walks.
I have mixed feelings, excited as well as very sad also that I'll be parting with both my daughters.
Supposedly we know that we are going to be, we are going to feel the aloneness now. But somehow, somewhere, I think wishing them a very wonderful journey together. No regrets.